Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Salt Lake Community College 2016 Commencement. We are pleased to have you here to honor this year's graduating class. Please welcome the Grand Marshal, faculty leaders, college faculty, and this year's graduates, led by the 2016 Graduates of Excellence.
Thank you.
Community College Distinguished Platform of Guests, and remain standing for the posting of colors and the national anthem. The colors will be posted by the United States Army West Valley City Recruiting Center, followed by the national anthem performed by May Lee Brown, an SLCC student.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. That star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Please help me thank Te Hamata, Utah Pacific Island called to welcome. It is my honor to welcome the 2016 graduates, the President's Party, faculty staff, family, and friends of our graduates. It is now my honor and privilege to turn the program over to our President, Dr. Denise Hoftalen.
Welcome. Thank you so much for joining us for this joyous and celebrative event. It is truly an extraordinary day as we celebrate 67 years of educational excellence and student success. This year, over 4,100 students will graduate from the college with either a certificate or a degree. Thank you for making it a priority to honor their accomplishments. I am joined on stage this morning by incredible supporters of Salt Lake Community College and its students. And it's my privilege to introduce our special platform guests. As I introduce each one, I ask that they stand and remain standing until all introductions have been made. Also, please hold your applause until all of the introductions have been completed. Our honorary doctorate recipients for 2016, Stanley Parrish and Barbara Tanner. Members of the Board of Regents of the Utah System of Higher Education, France Davis, Vice Chair, Marlon Jensen, Bailey Beauthorpe, Jessely Anderson, Joyce Valdez. Representing the Utah System of Higher Education, Dr. Kimberly Henry, Associate Commissioner. Representing Westminster College, Dr. Stephen Morgan, President. Our Board of Trustee members, Clint Ensign, Vice Chair, Maria Farrington, Annie Schwemmer, Alumni President, Jim Wall, Tim Miller. Representing the SLCC Foundation Board, Roger McQueen. And representing the Staff Association, Julia Ellis, President. Our student leaders, Carlos Moreno and Arturo Salazar. SLCC Administrators and Executive Cabinet, Dr. Clifton Sanders, Dr. Charles Lepper, Barbara Grover, Allison McFarland, Tim Sheehan, Dr. Roderick Land. Our academic deans, Dr. Eric Heiser, Dr. Dennis Bromley, Dr. Craig Caldwell, Dr. John McCormick, Dr. Joanne Wright, Richard Scott. This year's Grand Marshal, Curtis Youngman. Our keynote speaker, Gretchen McLean. Thank you to you all. You may be seated. I am also honored to introduce an additional platform guest, our 2016 Distinguished Alumni Award recipients. Please stand as I introduce you and remain standing. Marisa Egbert. Marisa discovered her love for civil engineering during a pre-engineering class at Salt Lake Community College, where she attended with an athletic scholarship playing women's basketball. She transferred to Utah State University and earned her Bachelor's of Science in Civil Engineering. In 2000, Marisa became the state coordinator for Math Counts, a national nonprofit foundation that strives to engage students of all ability and interest levels in fun and challenging math that expands their academic and professional opportunities. The Utah program annually benefits approximately 500 middle school students, with more than 60 participating schools statewide. Over the past decade, her relationship with SLCC has come full circle through her work with Math Counts at the annual competitions every February and March on our SLCC Taylorsville Redwood campus. Marisa is a registered professional engineer in the state of Utah and has worked for the Utah State Division of Water Resources for the past 11 years. We are so happy to present this stole of gratitude to Marisa, our 2016 Distinguished Alumni. Our second Distinguished Alumni recipient is Gerard Ford Kraft, who unfortunately had a prior commitment and is unable to be with us this morning. Gerard received Food and Wine's Best New Chef and Innovator of the Year Awards. He was one of Inc. Magazine's Star Entrepreneurs Under 30. Additionally, he won the James Beard Foundation Best Chef Midwest Award. To say that Gerard has found success as a chef and businessman would be an understatement. The foundation upon which Gerard continues to build his niche in the culinary world took shape at Salt Lake Community College's Culinary Arts Institute at the Miller campus. At the age of 25, Gerard opened the restaurant Niche in Missouri and has since extended his offerings as part of the Niche Food Group in St. Louis to include three additional restaurants, with one expected to open in Nashville in summer 2016. He lives in St. Louis with his wife Susan and their two daughters. Gerard was presented with his stole of gratitude at a previous college event, but please help me congratulate Marisa and Gerard. We are proud to honor you as distinguished alumni. This year, 44 students, the most in college history, are graduating with the distinction of a civically engaged scholar. One of Salt Lake Community College's values is community, community engagement, and one way we focus on this value is through designated service learning courses. This high-impact teaching practice engages students in both service to the community and in reflective thinking about community needs and assets. This year, 5,722 students enrolled in more than 287 service learning courses. To graduate as a scholar, students must complete a rigorous combination of service learning coursework, volunteer hundreds of hours with nonprofit agencies, and participate in cohort workshops and social justice training, all while maintaining a 3.0 GPA. This year's cohort of scholars served over 111,000 hours in our community. Also, as a fully engaged department, all students graduating from our occupational therapy assistant program automatically graduate as civically engaged scholars. Would our civically engaged scholars please stand and be recognized? And would those faculty who embed service learning in their coursework also stand for recognition? Thank you. Congratulations. I also have the pleasure of introducing and acknowledging the outstanding achievements of some of our faculty this year. These award recipients are seated to my right in the front row of the faculty section. I'd ask each recipient to stand following the announcement of their name and to remain standing. Please hold your applause until all of the introductions have been made. The 2016 Teaching Excellence Award for full-time faculty were awarded to Dr. Jane Drexler, Associate Professor, School of Humanities and Social Sciences, Humanities, Language, and Culture Department. Maquette Sorensen, Associate Professor, School of Humanities and Social Sciences, Social Work Program. The 2016 Teaching Excellence Award for Adjunct or Part-Time Faculty was awarded to Dr. Ron Carpenter, Adjunct Faculty, School of Humanities and Social Sciences, English Department. And the 2017 Distinguished Faculty Lecture will be presented by John Close, Professor, School of Science, Mathematics, and Engineering, Mathematics Department. I would also like to acknowledge our faculty governance leadership and commencement processional leaders, Adam Dastrup, Acting Faculty Senate President, and Louise Baum, Faculty Association President. Before we get to the celebration of our honorary doctorates and you graduates, there are thousands of other folks today worthy of praise. Graduates, many of you have family and friends here today celebrating your accomplishments. Parents, godparents, aunties, uncles, children, siblings, coworkers, friends, partners, faculty members, and fellow students. And while some of you may be here alone today, my guess is that someone has cheered you on throughout your educational dreams. So before I share my remarks, let's pause and thank those good people. They may not walk across the stage today, but they have been figuratively walking alongside you this entire time. To those on the stage or in the audience here who have celebrated and supported a graduate today, will you please stand so that your graduates can recognize you? Thank you. So every good story has an arc. It's rare that a day goes by when I don't hear a story from a student or their family about how this place has changed their life. And the beginning of the story often begins with their own personal doubt. doubt in their intellect, doubt in their abilities, doubt in their finances. Doubt that they will have what it takes, or that they can write an essay, or that they can meet a deadline or speak in front of a group of people. And then somewhere in the middle of that story, there's an event that triggers an awakening, a difficult assignment, a critical dialogue in class, a new relationship that challenges assumptions and exposes them to new ideas. And then there's a reconciliation, a triumph, an understanding that leads to a new sense of self, a realization that they belong here, that they've changed, that they are smart, that their future is bright, and that they've learned and grown and become something they did not think possible. Doubt, experience, awakening, becoming. It's the makings of a classic story. So this day marks the formal ending to this particular story in your life. Today, there are more pages to the left of your SLCC book than to the right. The final chapter is in your hand. But the beauty of life is that there are parallel stories occurring all the time. And while this chapter may be ending, in other parts of your life, you're blessedly in the middle, or just starting out, or perhaps even picked up, you haven't even picked up the book yet. My hope for you today is that you take some time to reflect on this particular story arc, to realize the changes that have occurred in you during your time and to celebrate them. If we have done our job, then you have changed. You have more content knowledge, more skills, a deeper sense of passion. You can critically think about opposing views and discover and defend your view while respecting others for theirs. You can consider ideas from multiple disciplines. You have created friendships with people vastly different than yourself. And you realize the privilege of an education and the importance of continued learning and giving back. This transformation story arc was reinforced recently at our Graduates of Excellence Luncheon, where I had the pleasure of meeting and hearing from our academic deans as they introduced our Graduates of Excellence, who you will meet later in the program. Each of them is remarkable and shared unique stories of overcoming obstacles and doubt to achieve tremendous goals and accomplishments. One graduate, Vanessa, shared how she had successfully journeyed through her own doubt by using her studies in psychology, namely Abraham Maslow's mantra, "What a man can be, he must be." Vanessa describes the doubt that haunted her as an older student, an immigrant, learning psychology while learning English. "I'm too old, I'm too late, I'm too much, I'm too little." But through her resilience and by conjuring Maslow's premise, Vanessa persisted through and achieved in honor of her mother. She not only earned a spot on the president's list, she's not only a graduate of excellence, but she found engagement with Phi Theta Kappa. She advocated for mental illness with the psychology club. She advocated for equity with the diversity and multicultural department. And she strengthened her voice through the Feminist Majority Leadership Alliance. Vanessa now sees her strengths, her power, and she plans to double major in psychology and ethnic studies at the University of Utah to empower other immigrants, first generation, divorced, widowed, or single mothers to find their own voice. Her story ends with these beautiful words: "This is my time to become. This is the space where I will. SLCC will always be my home, the place I learned I can be." Graduates, as you close this chapter, remember the pen is still in your hand. And as Natasha Bedingfield implores us, live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins. The rest is still unwritten. Congratulations, graduates. I am now pleased to introduce an extraordinary person who continues to be a remarkable champion of the college, Clint Ensign, Vice Chair of Salt Lake Community College's Board of Trustees, who will introduce our honorary doctorate recipients.
As Vice Chair of the Salt Lake Community College Board of Trustees and on behalf of the Utah State Board of Regents, it is my honor to present Stanley B. Parrish as honorary doctorate recipient of Salt Lake Community College for 2016. We recognize Stan for his longstanding community and college service, for his extensive business and public service and leadership. As the Chief of Staff for Senator Orrin Hatch and as the Associate Deputy of the U.S. Business Administration and the Governor's Executive Director of Community and Economic Development, Stan has provided decades of counsel and advice regarding the economic health of our state. He has also provided tremendous support and advocacy on behalf of Salt Lake Community College as a trustee. He has served for 11 years as a trustee for us. In recognition of his business and political acumen, his longstanding service to our state and to our college, and for his belief in the transformative power of community and college and education, I am pleased to confer upon Stanley B. Parrish the title of Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights and privileges attendant to it. Please join me in congratulating Stan Parrish. Now my pleasure to introduce a rare and remarkable woman. As Vice Chair of the Salt Lake Community College Board of Trustees, and on behalf of the Utah State Board of Regents, it's my honor to present Barbara L. Tanner as the honorary doctorate recipient of the Salt Lake Community College Class of 2016. We recognize Barbara for her outstanding philanthropic and community engagement throughout the state. Barbara has lent her leadership vision, her advocacy, and her financial support to many critical and culturally defining entities in Utah, including the Utah Youth Village, the Utah Symphony, the Gina Backauer International Piano Competition, and her namesake, the Barbara L. and Norman C. Tanner Center for Nonviolent Human Rights Advocacy at the University of Utah. In recognition of her dedication to the building Utah's community through her support of the arts, education and environment, and human rights, I am pleased to confer upon Barbara L. Tanner the title of Doctor of Humane Letters with all the rights and privileges attendant to it. Please join me in congratulating Barbara Tanner.
Thank you. Congratulations.
In an effort to celebrate more deeply the commitment to teaching and learning at Salt Lake Community College, each of our academic deans has selected a graduate of excellence to represent their school. The graduates were selected based on academic achievement, involvement, and leadership at Salt Lake Community College. Community service or notable contribution to the creative arts, athletics, or the environment. Graduates of excellence, please stand as I introduce you. Katerina Granucci, School of Applied Technologies and Technical Specialties. Trung Tam, School of Arts, Communication, and Media. Fabrin Soonolote, School of Business. Joelle Merriman, School of Health Sciences. Vanessa Wilkins, School of Humanities and Social Sciences. Lilith Draper, School of Science, Mathematics, and Engineering. Ashley Baker, General Studies. Congratulations to our graduates of excellence.
My name is Trung Tham, and I was born and raised in Salt Lake City, Utah, and I'm graduating with the Fashion Design program.
This is one of my outfits for my collection, and it's a two-piece denim chambray look.
My approach of fashion is kind of organic. My whole inspiration for this my collection this year is inspired by glamping, which is like glamorous camping.
I have a lot of personal touches to them. That's one of my favorite things about designing, just embellishing and making it really personal.
I feel even the place where we live is super inspirational, like the landscape.
This is organza with red feathers. These are kind of inspired by fly fishing. I was camping and my friend was fly fishing, and the little cute flies that they hook to the fishing pools. So it's a little bit, but not too loud. Nothing screams camping or anything.
I would tell anyone who was interested in the fashion program that it's amazing and really hard, and you have to put in a lot more work than you think. You think it's very glamorous, and it's really hard, but worth it. There's a lot of good people here. I think Salt Lake was a really good foundation for my fashion career.
I'm Lilith Draper. I live in West Jordan with my husband and four kids. I'm graduating with an associate's degree in general studies and a degree in nursing. All right, so we're gonna see a few students here. This is a scenario room. The challenge was always, because it is a scenario, let's make sure this patient doesn't die on our watch. So those scenarios got pretty stressful. I learned so much here at Salt Lake Community College. The biggest thing was how to interact socially in the big world. I grew up in the FLDS church with several mothers and one father, of course. Our parents raised us with really good work ethics. Everyone pitched in, we worked hard. A lot of good values, just not a lot of interaction with the world. So when I first began college here, I stayed to myself. I was very reserved and on purpose didn't interact with a lot of people because I judged myself very harshly based on how I was raised. And then I met quite a few wonderful people that helped me to realize that everyone's not just looking at me. If it's okay to be yourself, find out who you are, and have fun here in college.
Hi, my name is Fabrin Sotnalote. I'm actually named after my grandmother. My middle name, Himalaya, is her name. 3 years ago, my grandma passed away. So I ended up on the internet looking for just things to kind of help me get going. And I found a saying that says, "Beyond fear, I stand." So when I do say the saying, "Beyond fear, I stand," I think of my grandma a lot, and I can actually see her face sometimes and hear her voice. I don't feel like I would be here without her. First off, when I started, was finding support to actually come to college. Most of my family never went to college, so I'm officially the first one in my family to even graduate. And actually for myself, like self-support to actually come, I took a semester off before pursuing college, so I was ready to just call it quits and keep working. And then I decided not to, because I remembered my grandmother. She kind of taught me early on, like, this is what you should be doing if you want to do this, and why not go after your dreams?
My name is Ashley Baker, and I'm graduating with my associate's degree in general education. Here we are. So right now we're in the Senate chambers at the Utah State Capitol. This is where I spent the last 3 months working as a communications assistant. And honestly, I was nervous about getting my general education degree, but I didn't realize that it would make me more marketable in the workforce because it does give me more skills. Like, I was able to kind of branch out and learn different things, like dabble in photography. And same with political science. I was able to learn about that and decide if that's the direction I want to go, or even journalism. So I just feel like having all of these skills really helped me get this job here. It's pretty cool. It was definitely an experience.
My name is Katerina Granucci. I am studying criminal justice, and I am from California.
I said, I think I did a decent job trying to summarize a 200-page bill in my paper.
My favorite experience at Salt Lake Community College was when I was taking a criminal justice cooperative education course, and we had, at the end of the class, to pick a research paper topic of our own choice, whatever we wanted.
This is the research paper that I wrote about House Bill 348 that passed in the 2015 summer legislative session.
I wanted something that wasn't researched yet. I wanted to be the one to initiate the research. I had a telephone conversation with a representative who was sponsoring the bill, and so we had a couple hour long discussion about it.
I just can thank my teachers for what they've done. Just the little things that my teachers have done along the way in my courses really impacted me. Without them, I wouldn't have gone the extra mile, and I will forever appreciate them and what they've done.
Hi, my name is Vanessa Wilkins. I live in West Valley City. I graduated from my psychology degree here at the Salt Lake Community College, and now I'm currently going to the University of Utah. This is my first semester. The Salt Lake Community College has been a blessing to my life. I mean, this was something I wanted to do years ago, but there was always something coming from a family of women that had tons of challenges, such as education. Access to education was really hard for my grandmother. My mom became a teacher, and I appreciated her example to value education this way. Now that I have a chance to come back to school, you know, I wanted to show my daughters that they can also do this. And this, me coming back to school, achieving the goals I have achieved, gaining self-confidence in myself, has, for them, become a turn point in themselves too, that like, mommy can do this, I can do it too. So coming to the college, making a decision to be here, was probably one of the best decisions in my life.
My name is Joelle Merriman. I grew up in Taylorsville, not far from the Redwood campus. I am graduating in the radiologic technology program. What makes me an excellent student is I tend to persevere. Several years ago, we had a very tragic thing happen in our family's life. And I was left to take care of all my 5 children all by myself. I didn't know how I was going to get out of this. I was a stay-at-home mom. In my application for the Graduate of Excellence Award, I wrote about what motivated me. The first couple of years after I had to support my children, I felt like I was barely treading water, surviving, not yet thriving. My children were depending on me, and it was sink or swim time. I remember researching program options available to me, finally deciding on one and making my plan of action. And I had a long list of small goals, and I pictured myself where I would be after I reached all of them. And it was a long list, and it just started with apply to SLCC. And that's where I began.
I am excellent.
You are excellent. We are excellent.
Porque nos estamos graduando del Salt Lake Community College.
Class of 2016.
We can go anywhere.
To get a bachelor's in nursing.
The University of Utah.
New York.
Weber State.
The U of U.
We can be anything.
Journalist.
Fashion designer.
Business marketing.
Nurse.
Criminal technician.
Consejera.
Radiation therapist.
Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias a todos. My name is Carlos Moreno. For the past 2 years, people have called me El Presidente. I'm so happy to be here this wonderful day to celebrate with each and every one of you. Today, I would like to talk about perseverance. The verb persevere comes from the Latin root perseverius, which means continuing steadfastly persist. Today, perseverance means to persist in a methodical way despite obstacles or distractions. I would like to give you three examples of perseverance, one from a church, one from a great leader, and the last one from my own life. First, nature is perseverant. Did you know that a Japanese bamboo seed doesn't know come to the surface to 7 years? An inexperienced grower might think the seed is infertile, but bamboo will grow over 100 feet in 6 weeks. For the first 7 years, the bamboo seed is dedicated to developing and strengthening the roots, which are going to bear the 100-foot growth. If the grower doesn't take care of the seed during those 7 years, the bamboo dies. Imagine a farmer who stopped watering his Japanese bamboo at 6 years and 11 and a half months. A little more patience and perseverance would have produced much fruit in a short time. Similarly, we may face situations where we believe that nothing is happening, and this can be extremely frustrating. Those who do not give up gradually and imperceptibly create habits and temperaments that allow them to sustain success when it's finally materialized. If you do not get what you crave when you crave it, do not despair. Maybe you are just taking root. The second, people are perseverant. In 1831, a man fell in business and went bankrupt. In 1832, he was defeated in a run for legislature. In 1835, his fiance died. In 1836, he suffered a nervous breakdown before being defeated in another run for office. In 1843, 46, 48, 55, he lost election for Congress. In 1856, he lost an election for vice president, and in 1858, he was defeated once again in the Senate election. In 1860, he was elected president of the United States. Abraham Lincoln was a stubborn, perseverant man. The lesson is simple. One only fails when one stops trying. Finally, I'm persevering. Being an immigrant to any country is hard. We have to learn the language, the culture, and adapt our awkward behaviors to our new home. It's made so much harder when you don't have money to survive. My country, my home country, Venezuela, abandoned more than 25,000 Venezuelan students abroad when they prohibited us from bringing our own money into the countries in which we are studying. These students have had to sleep in all-night restaurants and shelters, have had to beg for food, and while we are trying to be college students. I create an organization called Venezuelan Student Abroad to denounce this situation to international community. The Venezuelan government was not happy with my activism and call me traitor and conspirator. But but I persevere. I persevere, and I was invited to a meeting at the Organization of American States with the General Secretary Luis Almagro, and with the International American Commission on Human Rights in Washington, D.C. We are looking for options for our students. I know we will have a good result. As I look across the crowd, I see perseverance everywhere. Those who have overcome family problems, financial challenges, health struggles, and mathematics. Yeah, I know. Today, you are showing us the best version of yourself. Today, all of you exemplify what makes the difference between success and failure. Simon Bolivar, the hero of Venezuela, said, "For achieving success, it has always been essential to go through the path of the sacrifice. Each of you has sacrificed your families, your family has sacrificed for you. This morning, I applaud everyone here, and I ask that you join me to recognize the collective sacrifice we have all made and celebrate with the best standing ovation." Before I finish, I would like to thank our amazing staff and faculty. They see us with eyes of perseverance. I would like to ask my fellow Bruins to give them a round of applause. I would like to thank my family, especially my wife, who has been a great support during this challenging time for our family. Also, I would like to thank my Heavenly Father for his protection and love during this time at Salt Lake Community College. Okay. I would like to dedicate my fellow graduates a quote from El Quijote. "As you are not experienced in the things of the world, all the things that are a big difficult seem impossible to you. But the time will come, and I will tell you some of the things I have seen, which will make you believe in everything I have just told you." I would like to say it in Spanish, which, in my opinion, sounds better. "Como no estás experimentado en las cosas del mundo, todas las cosas que tienen algo de dificultad te parecen imposibles. Confía en el tiempo, que suele dar dulces salidas a muchas amargas dificultades." Go Bruins. Okay, today I have to introduce our special guest. Gretchen W. McLean is an accomplished business leader from a strive of energizing organizations and building businesses by enhancing innovation and developing exceptional leadership talent, with more than 25 years of global experience in both Fortune 500 corporations and government service, including serving as a founding CEO of an S&P 500 global water technology company and NASA chief director of International Space Station. Gretchen graduated from University of Utah with a Bachelor of Science in Mechanical Engineering and receiving the University prestigious Founder Day Award in 2015. She was inducted into the Utah Technology Council Hall of Fame and is the first woman to receive this honor. Please help me to welcome Gretchen McClain.
Good morning. I'd like to take a moment to thank your president, Denise Hoffelin, the board of trustees, distinguished guests, faculty, family, and friends, and graduates for allowing me to mark this special occasion for you today. To the class of 2016, congratulations. It's so great to see the joy on your faces as new graduates. You've got to be so, so proud. Being here for me is so very inspiring. However, I have to tell you, and be honest, it's a little bit ironic. You see, way back when I finished college, and I was sitting in your shoes, or standing in your shoes, 30 plus years ago, I walked a different path. I attended the University of Utah and studied engineering. And by the time I was done, even though I loved being a student, I was finished. I secured my degree, and I wanted nothing else to do but to think about my future. I had lined up a temporary engineering job, and I was getting ready to move back east. I was focused on my future, and I didn't attend my own graduation. I didn't walk on graduation day. Despite the push from my parents, I went hiking on that day. I didn't think I needed the formality of graduation. And it's funny that just recently I was asked by the University of Utah Dean of Engineering about what I remembered about my graduation ceremony. And I was embarrassed, and I hated to admit that I didn't walk that day. I truly regret that decision, because graduation day is a day to remember. It's a day to celebrate all that you've achieved and to thank all those who have helped you along the way. It's a day to mark the end of one phase of your life and the beginning of a truly exciting and new chapter in your life. So, class of 2016, before I say and do anything else, I hope you don't mind that I steal a bit of your time so that I can take a selfish selfie of myself in this gown. Because you've all given me the chance to celebrate my graduation with all of you. So it's better late than never. Thank you. Seriously, I do want to take a moment now and do what I wish I would have done in the first place. So join with me. Look to your right, look to your left, and drink it all in. Save the memory to your mental hard drive, and yes, it's okay to take a selfie, but make it quick. Wave to your parents or to your favorite teacher, and say thank you. Okay, but above all, thank yourself for all the hard work that you've done to get yourself here today. Savor this moment and remember it. It's a big deal. Education is transformative. It's day one of your new life. President Hoffelin asked me to share with you some of what I've learned in my career and in my life today. And this is one of the most important lessons. Remember to stop and appreciate where you are at every stage of your career and of your life, and thank those who have helped you get here. Take the time to celebrate what's right in our lives instead of what we do all too often, focus on what's wrong, the mistakes we've made, or the mistakes we will make. The second lesson I want to share with you today is just as important. When you leave today and begin your new career or your pursuit to higher education, don't believe anyone who says you can't do something or you're not up to the task. Believe in yourself. What I'm talking about is more than perseverance. It's about having a deep gut belief in what you're capable of and the courage to not let any naysayers or your nerves get in your way. It's about knowing the difference between confidence and overconfidence, and understanding that being open to learning at every phase of your life is a strength. When the job that you want seems out of reach, learn everything you can about it. Use learning to lift you. Learning will always help you defy the odds. And it's clear you already have a lot of experience in defying the odds by some of the examples shown today and hearing some of your stories. Slick students are tough, right? More than half of you worked while you attended school, somehow managing the balance of the demands of a job and the demands of a classroom. Some of you did all this while also balancing the demands of raising a family. Right? Tough work. Many others don't have to go through that. Many are the first in your families to pursue an education, true role models for your family and for your community. And nearly 3 out of 4 of you will go on to a 4-year college to gain your bachelor's degree. That is outstanding. All of you are trailblazers, refusing to take no or it's too hard as an answer. In my experience, this determination is one of the most important ingredients for success in your work and in your life. Early in my career, I had the opportunity to work for NASA, helping design the International Space Station, which has been visible over the Utah skies over this past month. And I hope some of you saw it on one of those late nights when you were finishing your last finals or finishing that last project that was due. Helping bring the International Space Station to life was an opportunity of a lifetime. But getting to that position at NASA was no easy task. I was competing against so many other students and colleagues that had gone off to Ivy League schools, and they had much fancier credentials than I did. But I knew that my education was just as good. Think about it. We all use the same books. We all take basically the same classes. At least that's what I told myself, and I convinced my inner self that I was just as strong. And while there were times I didn't feel as smart, I was always able to hold my own. Being the underdog drove me to work around the clock to learn and to keep learning, to not be afraid to ask the experts for help, and to surround myself with people who were smarter than me. As a result, I actually gained an edge. Yet there were still times along the way when I was rising in the ranks, I was told, you don't have the experience or you'll never get that job. But I kept pushing anyways. I was persistent. And I proved them wrong. I got my dream job to oversee the launch of the International Space Station. I remember thinking at that time, this is it. I've arrived. But there were so many more challenges and doubts to overcome. Which leads me to lesson 3. If you're not already, get comfortable being uncomfortable. Growth and comfort do not coexist. At least it never has in my life. During my time at NASA, the Cold War was ending, and the United States and Russia were joining forces for the first time. After competing for so many years for the race to space. Bringing together teams of engineers, astronauts, and cosmonauts from the US and Russia was no easy task. Tensions were high, and the language barrier made it worse. While the Russians already had a space station in orbit called the Mir, it was near the end of its life, and it was underfunded. Yet we decided that conducting joint Shuttle Mir missions would be an important way to prepare for the eventual launch of the International Space Station. While the Mir was old, a platform that needed repair, we believed we would be able to provide valuable opportunities to learn from each other and to be able to get through some challenges that we would eventually see on the International Space Station. But we had no idea of the high points and the low points, and the high drama from the internal critics to the external doubters to the technical challenges we would face. One of those scary days was when I stood in a Russian manufacturing plant. We were evaluating the Mir docking adapter, which our space shuttle would have to connect to when it reached the Russian space station Mir. We were leaning over this big table, and there were no computers in sight. And we were looking at the drawing, the master blueprint of the Mir docking adapter. And it had pencil and eraser marks all over it. And all I could think of was, how on earth were we going to be sure that this was going to work when the Mir docking adapter was already in space? Though an engineer, my new job was not operations. It was all about leadership, bringing everyone together, our arch enemies, to build trust and ensure mission safety was never compromised. The enormity of the task was overwhelming, and I had still so much to learn. With the world and the politicians constantly looking over our shoulders, our men and women worked through issues face to face. I had to learn to quiet my own internal doubts and have faith in myself as a leader and have trust in our joint teams. We had Russians working side by side with our U.S. specialists at NASA facilities. We had talented U.S. engineers in Russia for months at a time. And we had American astronauts living on a formerly secret military base, and they would soon be living on the Mir space station. We were building trust with each other. And in between my 30-plus trips to Russia during that period of time, I stood tall in front of the politicians and the internal naysayers with sound plans and confidence in our actions. Fast forward, we executed a seamless shuttle docking to the Mir space station, a complete success. However, no one would have expected what would come next in the program. Yes, a fire on the Mir, and the day a supply ship actually collided into the Mir and caused decompression when one of our astronauts was on board. Despite the adversities that we saw, the highs and the lows, the perseverance and the underlying dedication of our teams together, believing in one mission, trusting one another, stretching each other, believing in ourselves, the Shuttle Mir program was a success. And to this day, when I see the International Space Station fly over our night sky, I still have that same feeling of pride yet unbelievable anxiety as I did standing in Kazakhstan on November 18, 1998, touching the Proton launch vehicle 36 hours before our first launch of the International Space Station. What that experience showed me is that every leader has moments of doubt and anxiety, and you will as well. But I truly believe, it's the tension between the butterflies and the confidence in our stomachs that keeps us moving forward, producing our greatest work. It's that stretched feeling that gives us the energy and focus to accomplish feats we never thought possible. The fourth lesson I want to share with you is make your work and your life matter. After I left NASA, I built a career in the commercial aerospace, which was one of the most cutting-edge industries at that time. Then one day, I decided to pursue a new direction, water technology. I became intrigued by the growing urgency surrounding water. Water scarcity, the quality of water, the amount of energy to move water to people who need it. I found myself drawn to this issue for a number of reasons. First, it was an incredible, global, profitable business that was bringing new innovation and new technology to bear in the marketplace. But this was business with an amazing higher purpose. And I believed that if we could truly work together, government and industry, we could make a difference in the world on one of the biggest challenges of our time. We had the chance to improve and even save people's lives around the world. My colleagues and I went on to launch the world's largest standalone company and then take it public. It was a privilege to be able to travel the globe and see how our work was making a difference. And it has been one of my most profound experiences of my life. Let me just share one of those stories, and it is my last story. I was on a trip to Calcutta, India, where our company was working with some of the local communities to deliver new water technology to communities that were in dire need. And we had the chance to go visit a small school in a remote area where we were going to help them provide safe water and sanitation, and actually some of the work had already been done. This was critical for the children in the area because due to the lack of running water and working bathrooms, many of the kids, and especially the girls, simply dropped out of going to school as they matured. We drove for hours outside of the city on one of those hot, sticky days, and we finally arrived at this small village where we were greeted by a small crowd of the students that attended the school. They were waving, jumping up and down, and so excited to see us. I was deeply moved. And then we walked around the corner towards the school. I was speechless. There were hundreds of children cheering for us and throwing rose petals at our feet. And as we got to the center of the schoolyard, the head teacher snapped his fingers, and there was not a word to be heard amongst those hundreds of children until he asked them to sing a song for us. When they were finished, one little girl came up and took my hand, and she walked me to the new girls' restroom. She was so excited to show me the taps on the sink and the mirror that was on the door. As I looked into the mirror, all I could see was this little girl beaming back at me, a little girl who was so proud to go to school with running water. I saw a little girl with hope in her eyes, and I thought to myself, we did this. My company made this happen. It's amazing to feel great about the work you do. Always try and tie your work to a higher purpose. You've had many great role models here at the Salt Lake City Community College, faculty and staff who have gone the extra mile to give you a chance to learn and to support you and help you grow. Bring that same passion and dedication to your work. In almost every job, there's an element of helping someone. And if you can achieve your success while also impacting the world, in my experience, it's a dream come true. So to summarize, appreciate what you have at every stage in your career and life. Celebrate today, you deserve it. Don't let anyone tell you you can't do something when you know you can. And don't second guess yourself. Get comfortable being uncomfortable, as growth and comfort do not coexist, and make your career matter. Embrace your individuality, but also the we. Look for ways to put your talent to work for the greater good. These are my four guiding principles that have shaped my life, and I hope you'll think about them after you leave today's ceremony. Each of you is ready to thrive in your career or in your pursuit of higher education. You've all fought hard, made sacrifices to get your degree. You all know how to manage through obstacles and get things done. The world needs your talent and your determination. We need your fresh ideas, your passion, and your energy. We need you to succeed. Everyone in this audience today knows you will, right? Class of 2016, savor today and everything you've accomplished so far. You did it. Then look forward and get ready. It's all systems go. The sky is the limit. Congratulations and Godspeed to you today and for the rest of your lives. Thank you.
Wasn't that outstanding? Have another round of applause. Thank you so much, Carlos and Gretchen, for your words of deep inspiration to our students. And congratulations, graduates, on accomplishing your educational goals at Salt Lake Community College. As you move into the next phase of your life, whether it be to continue your education or to begin your career in the workforce, we wish you the very best in your future endeavors. And now, will the graduates please stand? And will Trustee Ensign please join me at the podium? All right. Trustee Ensign, as Provost of Salt Lake Community College, I have the honor of presenting these wonderful students who have fulfilled the requirements established by Salt Lake Community College for their degree, diploma, or certificate, and are therefore recommended by the faculty for this appropriate honor.
As Vice Chair of the Board of Trustees of the Salt Lake Community College, I congratulate and accept these graduates. Congratulations.
Graduates, in just a few moments, you will be crossing this stage as a graduate of Salt Lake Community College. And while you may believe that you are leaving this institution, we believe that you are just joining us anew, this time as part of the SLCC Alumni Association. You will soon join the ranks of thousands of other SLC students who have moved from graduate status to alumni status. We hope that you will stay connected to Salt Lake Community College by taking advantage of programs, events, and other opportunities we have to offer. And we hope that someday you'll give back to Salt Lake Community College in time by sharing your time and talents with the college. Now, graduates, please follow the usher from your seat to prepare for the processional. Exciting, yeah? Thank you all for joining us again today, and thank you, graduates, for being such amazing representatives of Salt Lake Community College. So, in a moment, there will be a recessional of the President's Party, and we ask that you will stay in your seats until the platform guests have left the arena. And then we would ask that you, parents and families, meet your students outside. It's probably the easiest way to find one another is to go out and text each other where you want to meet so that you can find one another. We hope that you enjoy a phenomenal afternoon celebrating with your family and friends, and we want to thank you for your attendance at our 2016 commencement. Now, graduates, I have one last instruction for you. Please stand. Your tassel should be on the right side. You can now change it from right to left. You have officially graduated.
Tonight's gonna be a good night. I feel it. tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I'm feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I'm feeling tonight's the night. Let's do it. Here we come.